What's good, YouTube? It's your boy TSO Sage, and I'm back with another video.
I see what you got going on. Okay, y'all, I see you.
I asked you for 1,000 likes. You got me 1,000 likes, and here's the part two. Or better yet, the Eastern edition of me naming one thing wrong with your favorite team right now, because trust me, it ain't perfect. As I said in the last video before we get started, I'm fully aware that we're still pretty early into the season. Rotations, roster, hell, even the coach may change. But I'm just calling out what your team got going on right now, okay? And don't be sensitive. I'm gonna make fun of your team, spoiler alert. So without further ado, if you guys like the video, don't forget to like the video and let's get right to it. Starting off with the Washington Wizards.
I mean, do y'all believe that y'all are this good, or like, do you want me to tell you that you're not this good? Like, how do you want to go about this?
As of this recording, you guys have beaten the Raptors, the Pacers, the Celtics, the Hawks, the Celtics again, the Grizzlies, the Bucks, the Cavs, and the Magic. And considering you got 2 wins against Boston while nobody in Boston likes Jason Tatum right now, the only wins I can legitimately say, yeah, y'all got that shit, is the Grizzlies and the Bucks. Now, I'm not calling you guys completely Mickey Mouse, and I will give credit where it's due. Even if the Wizards are beating up on bad teams, that's a huge step for them considering that they're a bad team. But yet the issue for this franchise will simply be if you guys have the mindset that you're a top three team in the Eastern Conference. Yeah, watch how you fuck this season up. And by the way, before I move on, where's the 20 point per game MIP Kuz takes at, bro? Every day he has a good game, you guys tag me and spam me and DM me all this shit like I even just care about Kyle Kuzma that much. But clearly you guys watch him a lot, clearly you guys care about him a lot, and clearly you guys believe in him. While he's getting boards now, you know, whoa, shit, he's getting a rebound. Yeah, I want to know where those MIP lockdown 20 point per game Kuz takes are. Just let me know. The Chicago Bulls. My boy Vooch got a tee up, and not only does he got a tee up, he has to be able to score very well, get you around 20 points, but not need all 16, 17, 18 shots to get to those 20 points. The Chicago Bulls are the third seed in the Eastern Conference. They're perfectly fine, but their offense is clearly far from their best. And this is with DeMar DeRozan and Zach LaVine, you know, being DeMar DeRozan and Zach LaVine. By the way, DeMar DeRozan's even better than he usually is. And this is with Alonzo Ball that, outside of that one terrible night, has been on nothing but absurd timing, in my opinion. Simply put, the offensive system I'm seeing is looking pretty optimal. But Vooch gotta produce. He gotta put the ball in the basket. Well, not exactly being able to just ISO and dominate the ball, because if he dominates the ball, the offense isn't as optimal. And it's no shit, he's obviously in a slump because he's not this bad. But the Bulls could be a lot better, and it does start with him. The Miami Heat. Oh shit, it's the Jokic brothers. The New York Knicks.
So nobody gonna say it. I'm gonna be the guy that has to do this. Okay.
Orange Julius is like a really cool guy. He's a really solid player. But as long as he's their clear-cut number one, they don't have a shot, bro. They done added Kemba to fix the offense, and while the offense is a lot better than it was last season so far,
why is their defense bad?
Like, what the fuck? Why is it bad? Like, is Randle being an inconsistent player making the team inconsistent, or like, am I missing something? At least Derrick Rose is on timing again, so that's nice. The Toronto Raptors. When you build around a Blade, this is what happens. Psych, nah, but really, while I am impressed with Scotty Barnes, OG Anunoby, and Gary Trent, we're not sleeping on you either. You guys definitely have the defensive potential. Hell, you're playing good defense right now. But if y'all about to get stuck in the time loop of being mid, I ain't gonna lie, that is tough. The Milwaukee Bucks. Y'all niggas gotta be trolling or testing shit out, and I think it's the latter. While Giannis does have a new, smoother looking jumper, that bitch is not water yet. No cap. Give that shit back to Middleton, if anything, because dear Lord, he need it. And Drew Holiday bricking a lot too. He ain't safe. Hell, Brooke Lopez, if it ain't a three ball, it ain't going in. You're 7 feet. And outside of guys with even somewhat of a chip on their shoulder like Bobby Portis or Grayson Allen, y'all a bit lazy on defense too, no cap. Look, keeping it a buck is probably championship fatigue. I'm fully confident the Bucks will turn this around. I'm still gonna call them championship contenders. And even though it would even be fair to a degree to argue that they're doing the same shit that they've done, but they're just not locked in for real. They're just not making the shots. Guess the fuck what? I'ma tell you, lock in and make the shots, bro. Y'all just won a championship, you deserve a bit of rest. But time flies, we're already 12 games in. Don't coast too long and don't keep trying new things. Well, you know what you gotta do to get the job done. The Atlanta Hawks. So at first I was gonna go on Trae Young and his mindset that he should be getting a lot more calls than he is. And while I do admit the refs be wilding on him sometimes, I disagree with Trae. But with his performances as of late, even though he is losing, I can no longer really go on Trae. Besides, he's really just locked in and started balling. But that actually opened up a door for a new conversation that's kinda gonna hurt some Hawks fans' art, but it is possibly true. The Hawks' biggest issue right now is y'all might have peaked. And if you guys did peak, it's kind of at the worst time too, because yeah, some teams are underperforming right now, but majority of those teams, I look at them, I go, okay, this player's struggling, this coach is being an idiot right now, or whatever they got to do to fix it. The Hawks, I'm like, yeah, that's the Hawks, they just lost. But then it's over and over and over and over and over again. Hell, quite literally, you lost your last five. Like, the people who are struggling the most are lowest on the rotation right now. That is no reason your team is losing this much. The reality of the situation is the Hawks were set up to not play defense. But if you're gonna be this bad on the defensive end, my lord, can you at least give me more points? Considering how bad you are on defense, you're not scoring as much as you need to be. If it ain't Trae Young, they ain't no assists. And you're not even shooting that many threes. Look, whether you think it's deserved or not, we all recognize the fact that the Hawks definitely took advantage of opportunity in the playoffs. And I'm not completely writing the Hawks off considering it's still early in the season. Also, and let me be clear, I'm not saying that guys like Cameron Reddish, John Collins, and Trae Young himself have peaked in terms of talent. I'm talking about the team as a collective unit. And besides, the Hawks are nowhere near the only playoff team that's looking like they can't win a game right now. Several other playoff teams have a slow star performer, injuries, or even just literal fatigue as to why they can't win a game. ATL is not the only struggle. But if while every other team that's struggling in the Eastern Conference right now is just simply doing that struggling, while the Hawks on the other hand are literally looking like the Hawks and just taking the L along with it,
that's tough. I ain't gonna lie. If y'all niggas peak, y'all did this shit at the worst time. GG's.
The Orlando Magic. In the Western edition of this video, I definitely said that the Pelicans might end up being the worst franchise in the NBA. If it's not them, it's you guys. The fact that you guys are this bad and this injury prone is crazy. And after the Jokic brothers get done in Miami, they might come to Orlando just because. Shout out to Cole Anthony though, he's bald. The Brooklyn Nets. While I could easily go the James Harden foul baiting route, because even though he does have a good game and then a bad game, then a good game, then a bad game, he's doing it on purpose. He's testing out what he can get away with. But I'm not gonna complicate this, you know. Kyrie Irving is not playing basketball, which is really tough when you think about it, because Kyrie Irving gives the Nets that luxury, gives the Nets that third option that can go out there and drop 50. And while the Nets are certainly still a great offensive team, led by two of the greatest offensive players of all time, but if teams like the Golden State Warriors, Miami Heat, the Milwaukee Bucks, or even lesser teams have the ability to game plan, okay, this is how we can limit James Harden and Kevin Durant, rather than losing sleep at night and trying to play elite defense on three players for the Brooklyn Nets, it's quite literally more than half of the players a team is allowed to play at once. Game planning a rotation on a Joe Harris 3 turns into a, okay, we gotta live with a Joe Harris 3. You see the problem here? I don't know if Kyrie's gonna play. I hope he does because he's a great player. But until he does, all I'm saying is let's just pause our Nets final stakes for a second, if you even had him going there anyway. The Cleveland Cavaliers. So even though I was gonna basically say the same thing as the Wizards for you guys, with the injuries that just came out, man, no cap. Y'all just unlucky. I ain't even gonna say nothing else. The Philadelphia 76ers. Just trade him already. God damn. I'm being so serious. If I see one more Ben Simmons headline that's relevant, I'm gonna throw up. There was a process error. Ben Simmons and Joel Embiid are done. Whatever you wanna say, bro. Pack Ben up, holy hell, and there's no reason to wait till the deadline to do so. Y'all are starting to annoy me, if anything. The Charlotte Hornets. I can truly admit the Charlotte Hornets are definitely one of the five funnest teams to watch play basketball. On offense, holy shit, don't none of y'all play no goddamn defense. Now, this is to be expected. The team is really, really young. Like, the oldest player is Ish Smith, and considering he's a ninth man, I'd say it's really Gordon Hayward and Mason Plumlee at 31 years old. But I can only excuse them being young for so long considering how bad of a defense this is. After all, one, you gotta develop on that side of the floor, it looks like they just don't care about it. And two, when you look at the roster, they definitely have the defensive potential and physical capabilities of playing defense. Again, they just don't care about it. I'm not asking for some of these guys to turn into Tony Allen. I'm just asking for the team to not be one of the easiest teams to score against in basketball, considering they have a legitimate shot of making the playoffs. Either trade for some vets or tighten up. The Boston Celtics. The thumbnail probably gonna sell the views anyway, but you know why the thumbnail's there. One hitter quitter, TKO, Jason Tatum. You are not, and let me say it one more time, you are not Kobe fucking Bryant. And it's so weird because he's not supposed to play like Kobe Bryant. When you look at Jason Tatum, you see a guy that could be a bit more on the playmaking side and actually be one of those like 16 to 18 shot guys on really good efficiency. But he just wants to sidestep and post fade over two people all game. What the fuck?
suck.
Especially while Jaylen Brown is going off. And by the way, I'm not one of those people that feel like Jaylen Brown or Tatum gotta go because they can't play off each other. Bro, I tell you right now, let Boston get a better playmaker than Jeff Teague in 2020, Marcus Smart, or Dennis Schroeder, nobody's even gonna say these things. But whether it is the fact that he actually should just try to make himself fit better with Jaylen Brown and become the playmaker he can, or just simply turn down the volume and take better shots if you ask me. When Tatum said he was trying to take that leap from being a top 15 talent to a top 5 talent, him just shooting the ball all game over two people is not what I had in mind. Dog, relax. I still have high hopes for Jason Tatum. I'm not calling him a bum. He's still on the him scouting report, if you will. But you ain't gotta be Kobe Bryant, especially right now. Just be Jason Tatum, dog, please. The Indiana Pacers. Just nuke it already. Oh my God. Like, really, I'm not joking. Nuke it. With the talent on the Pacers roster, if healthy, yes, they can make the play-in or even the playoffs. But what's their peak? A second-round exit? A second-round sweep, really? Just to go on to not sign anybody major and not draft anybody major? Pacer fans, if you exist, I'm not trying to say that your team should just be trash and nobody cares about you, move on. I'm simply saying you have tons of potential to hit the reset button and do it properly. Like, literally, everyone that plays significant minutes for the Pacers is either entering their prime or literally in their prime right now and have like 4 or 5 more years to offer. I think right now is the right time to do it, but if anything, trade him a year early than a year too late, bro. Trade Brogdon when he's 29, not 32. Trade Sabonis when he's looking like one of the ascending talents and hasn't peaked. Trade Turner when damn near every team in the league want him. Fumbling the bag, bro. The Detroit Pistons. Yeah, so a lot of my predictions have been on timing, and the Pistons are definitely one of the misses, no cap. Kate just started playing good, and outside of him,
ain't nobody else looking that good, I ain't gonna lie.
Oh, and that Killian Hayes guy that y'all were trying to size in the offseason, yeah, he's terrible. Oh my goodness. But who wants a long segment on the Pistons anyway? That's gonna do it for today's video. It's been your boy TSO Sage. Got caught up with school, so that's the reason this upload is a bit later. But if we hit 1K likes in 24 hours, I'll upload tomorrow. If we don't, I'm gonna be on my bullshit. You already know how I get down. So if you like the video, hit the damn button, bruh. And if you like my content, subscribe, definitely hit that button as well. And this has been your boy TSO Sage. I'm gonna holla at y'all later. Take care and stay blessed.